In the last video, we saw that we could remove all these different type annotations and we did not see any errors. In fact, if we then hovered over these variables, it's clear that TypeScript still understands what type of value we're going to assign to each given variable. So what you're seeing here is the type inference system in action. In this video, we're going to discuss how type inference works and then discuss when we're going to rely on type inference versus adding in an annotation manually. So let's get to it. All right, so first off, the basics of type inference. Anytime you and I make a new variable inside of our application, we're actually undergoing two separate steps. So on the left-hand side of this equals sign, where we say const color, we're doing something called variable declaration. This is where we are telling our program that we're going to have a new variable inside of our application with the given name. And then in the second step of this entire process, on the right-hand side of the equals sign, we are attempting to assign a value to that variable. Assigning a value to a variable for the very first time is referred to as variable initialization. So this entire line of code right here, two separate steps, first variable declaration, and then initialization. Here's the rule around type inference. If we do our declaration and initialization on the same line, or essentially in one single expression, then TypeScript is going to figure out the type of value that we're going to assign to color for us. So in this case, TypeScript would look at the variable that or the value that we're using for initialization. It would see that this is a string, and it would say, okay, color must be a variable that's going to refer to a value of type string. And that's how we get this kind of pre-done type right here, where we can delete the annotation and TypeScript still sees what's going on for us. If I move this assignment or this initialization onto a separate line, then it's not going to work anymore. So if I say apples equals 5 on the next line down, if I hover over apples, you'll notice that it has a different annotation on here. It says any in this case. We're going to discuss with any means in just a moment, but for right now, I think you can agree with me that TypeScript can no longer figure out what type of value we're going to assign to apples. So again, the rule of thumb here is if we're doing the initialization and declaration on the same line, TypeScript will use type inference for us. Okay, so that's the kind of easy part of type inference. If we do everything on one line, everything's going to work just fine. So now here's the really obvious question. When are we going to add in these type annotations? When are we going to type them out? If we're saying that TypeScript can figure out these different types for us, why would we go through the process of writing out the annotations manually? And that's a great question. Let's take a look at a diagram to understand why we might want to use type inference over annotation, or the opposite. Okay, so in that file that we just put together, we've got a lot of examples of type annotations. So remember, that's where you and I, the developers, are going to tell TypeScript the type that a value or a variable is going to refer to. Now with type inference, that's where TypeScript is going to guess everything for us. So in general, we're going to rely on type inference always. All the time, wherever we can, we will rely on type inference. That means that whenever you and I have a variable that we are declaring and then initializing on the same line, you and I in this course are not going to add in type annotations. So we're going to have a lot of code that looks like this right here. And we will much more rarely have code that looks like this down here or anything else that you see inside this file. So we are going to rely upon type inference as much as we possibly can. But there are three scenarios where we will rely on type annotations. So let's take a quick break right here, and we're going to go through these three different examples of where we are going to add in these type annotations to help TypeScript out. So quick pause, and I'll see you in just a minute.